Welcome back to the Budget Gamer channel, where we bring you critical and in-depth reviews of just about every indie game we can get our hands on, and today we're going to be taking a look at Agelos for the Nintendo Switch. And yeah, I did actually look that up because I was not sure how to pronounce it, and apparently it's Greek for angels, or angelic. And this is actually one of those games that a long time ago I bought the physical copy for, but just now I got a chance to play it because it just now went on a crazy deep sale on the eShop. Which means I can finally play a game I've wanted to play for quite a while because I can play it for the channel. But getting back into the actual game review and divorcing myself of my own personal purgatory, Agelos actually has a story that is so true to the 16-bit era, it's almost comical. More or less, you find yourself an escaped captive who happens to be a princess wandering through a dark wood, and saving her from her would-be captors, you find yourself in Interview with the King, where you are then deemed as the champion of the world. And this, of course, begets you a mystical quest to unify the powers of the four elements to challenge the powers that be and hopefully save the universe from unforeseen peril. But while you might expect such a straightforward SNES-era story to get you a pretty straightforward and possibly even short experience, while the platforming itself is fairly straightforward, this little Metroidvania indie title actually gives you roughly 10 hours of gameplay if you actually dive in to see how much of an experience it really is. And despite the fact that probably at least 90% of this channel's viewership already knows the ins and outs and conventions of a Metroidvania, I'ma explain just a little bit anyway. Partially because I want the review to be longer than about 45 seconds, and partially because Agelos actually really deserves it because it does bring a lot of unique things to the table. In a Metroidvania, you expect a large interconnected map, and Agelos doesn't try to do that, it actually does that. Which is actually kind of funny because if you go into the maps and the menus, the map itself isn't very descriptive of where you're actually at in the game. And though that could possibly be reserved for the critique section, it is something to note that is actually distinctly different from your typical expectation for a Metroidvania. But it's the combat and special abilities of the game that I feel deserve probably the most praise just under its visual presentation. And that's because unlike a lot of Metroidvania indie titles that are flooding the eShop, Agelos doesn't attempt to block off or lock off certain areas of the map and kind of arbitrarily make you get a little bit more OP to blast your way into them. Agelos actually has distinctly unique areas that require special abilities to navigate your way through. And this is seen easily in just the first couple of power-ups that you get, the first one being the ability to actually turn enemies into platforms, which was a really novel way to avoid giving the player the most OP ability in any platforming game, which is the double jump. Instead, you have to develop a finesse and a very complete understanding of your character's jump dynamics in order to hit a moving enemy target with an arced blast to turn it into a usable platform at just the right moment. Other than that, bubble abilities aren't just used to be able to float in water, they're not just used to be able to float down through the air. They're actually a unique combat ability which is absolutely fundamentally necessary for boss fights past that level on. But if you're thinking that Agelos makes it absolutely uber easy with special abilities to move on through the combat, that's not exactly the case either. Because as much as you may want to use your new special abilities, you won't be able to more than about 3 or 4 times until you buy some significant upgrades, because the special abilities in the game are actually recharged by straight up melee combat. And so you'll probably never be able to break yourself completely away from the almighty S-word. And on that note, as far as game mechanics are concerned, Agelos isn't exactly just a straightforward Metroidvania either, and it actually does blend in some RPG elements. And this can not only be seen in the ability to purchase upgrades for your armor and your weapon, but also in the fact that there is an experience system. But one of the coolest things in Agelos is that, unlike a lot of other games that I've played that require leveling up, that require upgrading of new equipment, I never really felt like I had to. And that's possibly because there's not much more nuance put on the game than actually just developing your player skills. Platforming isn't meant to be the overall uber challenge of the game. Actually, most of the challenge in the game is devoted probably to boss fights. But thankfully, unlike truly arcade-style Metroidvania titles, there are a handful of checkpoints in the game that keep you from being punished too terribly much. But in the case of the boss rooms, every time you die, you will be sacrificing a bit of your experience, which, depending on your own personal playstyle, might cause you to invest a little bit more of your time in grinding. But moving on, and believe me, I've wanted to talk about this aspect of the game for the entire review up until right now, is the presentation of Agalos. Honestly, like I said before, I had the physical copy of the game, and I saw the cover art, and honestly, I thought it was just cover art. But the visual presentation for Agalos is absolutely artistic. And even though it's locked into a 16-bit palette, shading and color schemes and animations are pretty much some of the best I've seen for quite a while. And it does make me regret waiting this long to play it. Musically as well, this game is a true adventure, and Agalos really nurtures that player development and exploration through its soundtrack and keeping you invested in that kind of low-pressure hype that only a very applicable soundtrack can do. But not only the soundtrack, the sound effects package was incredibly well designed. There are different sound effects for different enemies, different types of attacks, and different enemy item drops. Nearly every single enemy will drop coins, but occasionally one drops a heart, and if you find yourself in a pinch, you're really going to want to know when that happens. And accordingly, a heart drop makes a different sound than a coin drop. But that being said, I can't say that Agalos is completely without critique, because as I've already mentioned, there's one glaring critique for the fact that this is a Metroidvania, and that is the map. The map for the game and the level design is honestly inspiring. It's very, very reminiscent of a true Metroidvania title, specifically probably Super Metroid, with lengthy backtracking required every time you uncover a new special ability or possibly uncover something that might be a random puzzle or quest. But that being said, with the requirement to backtrack through large interconnected world maps, you would expect to have a map, not a topographical land navigation course that merely shows a sculpted overview of a world. But even considering that, the level design was so well done, it wasn't really that taxing to keep a mental map in my own mind. Other than that, probably the only comment I could make to the game, and this is again very far from a critique, it's just player awareness, is that there is a pretty sizable disconnect from the average game difficulty curve to the difficulty of the boss fights. And this is actually one area that I explicitly praise Agalos, and that's because the boss fights to me literally felt arcade quality challenging, where you could imagine spending an entire allowance in quarters just to make it to the next level. But if you didn't grow up with that type of gaming environment, or you're a gamer who's more into the adventure and the exploration, you might actually see the boss fights as a bit of a gatekeeper. And if that's not what you're into, it might not be that pleasant. But despite the disparity between the serene valleys of gameplay and the Mount Everest that is the difficulty of the boss fights, there is nothing about Agalos that isn't fair, and so if you do take the time to learn and get a better control of your own character, you're going to triumph and come out successful in the end. And so just to clarify, again, the last note on the boss fights was not a critique, it was merely a note for player awareness. But anyway, that does about bring us to the end of the review of Agalos, not now on the Nintendo Switch, it's been on the Switch for a little while. So if you enjoyed the review, or especially if you found it helpful, feel free to throw us a comment or a like to show your support, and don't forget to click that little bell icon when you subscribe to stay updated with the latest content. Because we are putting out a couple of game reviews a week, and as I'm sure you are aware, if you've ever looked at the eShop, there are thousands of indie games out there, and new and unique ones are coming out every single day. And so whether it's an easy hard pass or an absolutely unforgettable gem, chances are if it's on the Switch, you're going to find out about it right here. But anyway, this has been the Budget Gamers. As always, thanks for watching.